Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to Cottonwood Castle! With your hosts, Casey Archer and Sarah Peters!
Good evening, everybody. This is Cottonwood Castle. I'm Casey.
And I'm Sarah.
And we just found out that we have so many viewers, about four, that we're just a hop, skip, and a jump away from going viral.
That's wonderful.
You know, I never knew that being viral was a good thing. I mean, if I went viral, I'd probably wind up with a restraining order.
But enough about Topher Grace. Tonight, we're actually here to talk about our good friend Justin Keats.
Yes, we actually have a top 10 favorite things about Justin Keats list.
Oh, really? Earlier this week, we actually had a round table with our good friends Christopher Retria and Hilary Kadoya.
Let's get a clip of that. Clearly a good time was had by all. On to our top 10 list, shall
that
we?
That sounds wonderful.
Well, ladies first.
Our number 10 on the list is he's tall.
That means he's good in getting those hard-to-reach places. Take that as you will. Number 9. He's good at picking out shoes.
Cha-ding! Da-dun-da!
Number 8. 2 a.m. Del Taco runs.
Ooh, gotta love the Del Taco. I don't think he's ever been over here at night without Del Taco in him.
Macho nachos without the beans.
Yeah, interesting. And Bean Pole doesn't eat beans.
That's ironic, isn't it?
Yeah. Sounds like cannibalism, but I think we're going to get that a little later. Number 7. He's good at being a fake boyfriend.
Oh, I know he's been mine at least 3 times.
Oh, really?
Oh, really?
Does he put out?
Ladies don't kiss and tell.
Ooh.
Or actually, they do.
Oh, do they?
That's after a few cocktails.
Boys don't.
Number 6 is bad movies.
Yes, and we had a little discussion about this with Chris and Hillary, didn't we? Roll the clip.
Well, every time Justin and I have gotten together and rented a movie, it's always been bad.
So he's not a good movie.
That could be it, or it might just be me, but I'm blaming him anyway. That's what I do.
Blame the people that aren't here. That's my motto.
Exactly. We watched Push, Sunshine Cleaning, which was not a comedy.
Yeah, sadly, I never returned those movies to Blockbuster, and now I own them. It was pretty bad.
That's terrible.
Number 5. Interesting comments.
Oh.
Remember what I mentioned about cannibalism earlier?
Why don't you
take it from here?
I do. I believe I got a text message at about 2 in the morning.
2 in the morning?
Asking, well, let's just say he had a few questions about cannibalism. Ew.
I wonder what meat he was chewing on. Yeah.
Number 4 is another very interesting comment.
Oh, is it?
Oh, yes. Shaving parties.
You know, I did get that text message.
Yeah?
There's something about shaving your entire body. Who
does
that?
I think we have a clip about that.
Oh, we do?
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
yeah, yeah.
Okay, let's
see it.
Did you want to join?
Wow.
That was a little awkward, wasn't it?
Well, you know, I think it's time to do something a little different.
Okay.
We are featuring a new segment this week called Shut Up and Learn Something.
Oh, this is my favorite.
It has to do with our number 3 reason that we like Justin Keats. And, you know, instead of me telling you, why don't we just let our modern dance expert, Tracy Viegas, let you know. Tracy?
Thank you. Modern dance is all about lines and expression. It's contorting the physical body to transpire into the realm of emotions. Modern dance is most serious, very serious, not to be taken lightly at all.
Thank you, Tracy. That was informative and stimulating. Especially those pictures. They were just stunning.
They were
It was all just
brilliant.
Like brilliant.
Yeah. That I think that one was my favorite
And what about the hula hoop?
I was unaware that hula hoops was such a common occurrence in modern dance.
Well, you know, I think it's some kind of metaphor for like the catch 22 that we all find ourselves in a day-to-day life.
That's profound.
Running in circles, you know?
Deep.
Like a well.
Well, let's move on.
Yes.
Our number two reason is jokes about sexual ambiguity.
Ooh, that sounds like a thrilling one. You know, I think we may have a reenactment of this very story.
I love it.
So let's play it.
Let's play it.
Hey guys, I just realized everybody here likes boys!
Oh, I'm not gay.
If I tell you that you're gay in this house, you're gay. It's science.
Awkward.
What? You guys, I'm not gay! I'm not gay! I'm not gay.
Wah, wah.
And now, the moment you've all been waiting for, our number one reason that we like Justin Keats the most. Hugs.
Are you sure that was number one?
Oh, that's actually number 11. I miscounted the ones. Sorry.
The real number one reason we love our Justin Keats, putting him on a shelf.
You don't say.
Oh, yes. He's great. He fits right there.
Isn't he kind of tall, though?
He is a little. I mean, it might take a little squishy.
Oh, why don't you show us how it works?
All right, I will.
I am putting you on a shelf. You're really tall. That'll work.
Well, that was fabulous, and I think we just had a fabulous time.
Oh, we did. It was wonderful.
Mm-hmm. You know, in all honesty, I just think that we are very excited to have Justin back with us eventually.
I am completely excited.
I know he's had a wonderful time in New York. I mean, you know, stopped texting us after a while, so
sure. I heard he ran into Neil
busy.
Patrick Harris.
I wonder if that hurt.
He looks kind of hard.
Ooh. Cannibalism. Anyway, that's about all the time we have for tonight. So from all of us to all of you, good night. This is Casey.
And this is Sarah.
And we're not wearing pants.
It's true.
Everybody got the whole arrow in her hand.
She's got the whole
arrow.
Can't
swim. She's got the whole arrow in her
hand.
Oh,
we're done. No, by going singing with.